To deal with the impacts of climate change and the increasing flood risks in particular, new grand spatial visions and narratives will be required. And this makes a new appeal to the imaginative power of the planning discipline and its ability to connect a wide range of values, disciplines and stakeholders. Spatial planners, in my opinion, especially need to develop their boundary-spanning capacities in order to be able to balance technical, communicative and adaptive rationalities. And that, in my opinion, is the challenge for the future.
That's an interesting perspective. In my view, for the upcoming decades, I think it's crucial that planners step outside of their office, outside their buildings, and get into the communities they're actually planning for. Talk to the local people. What are their dreams? What are their opinions? Which knowledge do they have? How can we, together, work towards a better future?
I feel that is very true. Yet, at the same time, I also feel that planners should become more and more knowledge brokers. The solutions of tomorrow for the problems of today are, by definition, transdisciplinary and multidisciplinary in nature. We simply need multiple kinds of knowledge.
Absolutely. But given the complex nature of cities, we should also work towards responsive and adaptive cities. Responsiveness includes a kind of alertness and willingness to engage with new developments. And then adaptivity is about the capacity to actually deal with unforeseen circumstances. So that's the dialogue I would like to start, responsive and adaptive cities.
In my opinion, planners can fulfill four different roles to work with society instead of for society. First, a value-based role to explore people's sense of place and how they attach meaning to their environment. Second, a community-sensitive role to identify the tipping points where transformations might happen. Third, a mediating role, looking at the differences between actors and opinions. And of course, we shouldn't forget the fourth role, addressing stories, imagination, and creativity.
Okay, let's not be such cowards. In the end, planning is about making distributional choices. And for a just city, we need to choose. We need to choose affordable housing, or social housing, of commercial real estate, and non-profit startup spaces over regular office spaces. As planners, we know how to envision a just city. But what we need to develop is tools to realize a just city.
Thanks. To add to that, I would say we need to be open explorers, to think what is possible, to be inspirational motivators for others, inspiring and exploring a sustainable transformation for society. And we need to find the courage to think beyond what's obvious and to explore these new ways together.
Yes, agreed. And then, based on top of all of this, at the end of the day, the planner is the one who lights the beacon, who sets an example, who gives us an image if we sail in that direction, if this is the general idea of our actions, things will be fine, problems will be solved, crisis will be averted, and better places will emerge.